today we are talking about selling a car in Kenya, which is quite a challenging and tedious affair. The car market in Kenya is flooded with imports and used cars. However, based on your reason to sell the car, its condition and the pricing, you can easily sell your car through many online options available for free and others that usually will charge some fee for you to advertise your car. So online advertising, there are many options through which you can advertise or sell your car, and we shall look at the most commonly used ones in Kenya by people wishing to sell their cars privately. So of course there is Facebook. Facebook is one of the most used online platform to sell items, from cars, houses, utensils, furniture, anything you can think about. It has hundreds of car selling groups and pages. Based on your expected price, you can list the car. Very many groups that have categorized themselves depending on the price of the car, or sometimes even on the make and model of the car. Like for instance, we have groups that are specialist groups or fan groups for vehicles like Honda, Peugeot, Toyota, Mercedes. If you have a car that is a make of a Honda, you can list it or you can put it up for sale in some of these interest groups. And something else about Facebook is that most people who have got smartphones will have access to Facebook, and that creates a favorable place for you to be able to dispose or to sell your car.
However, there's a word of caution though. When you're dealing in Facebook, there's a lot of risks, and all sorts of users are attracted by in Facebook, including serious buyers, brokers, and sometimes even fraudsters. So just ensure you follow the safety guidelines provided at the end of the video for your safety and that of your asset. The other website that is very popular with Kenyans wishing to buy a used motor vehicle is Checky, checky.co.ke. Checky has been around for quite some time. It's no doubt one of the most effective car selling websites that I have personally used. Its credibility was built on reasonable advertising fees during those days, which filtered out jokers, and users preferred buying cars from this online platform because of this fact. So, of course, people know if you're paying to advertise for your car, you're a serious seller. So most people prefer paid websites as opposed to free websites like Facebook. However, it's still very popular with car buyers because they know only serious people advertise their cars there. Checky is one of the most preferred websites by people wishing to buy vehicles. So if you feel you can spend a few coins in order for you to get serious buyers, so the minimum package is 2,900 shillings in Checky, and your car will be listed for 30 days or for 1 month. The other site that had been quite popular a few years back is OLX, which has since rebranded to Gigi. Okay, fine. OLX has one setback. It has been associated with conmanship in Nairobi or in Kenya. So many people have lost their money through conmen in OLX. So in as much as it's a free advertising website, but a lot of people are not comfortable with Gigi just for the fact that it is flooded with items that are not genuine, or probably with people who are not genuine sellers, and they just use pictures and lure people to send them money, and that's how people lose money. And currently they've also introduced charges. Probably about a year ago they started charging for advertising for motor vehicles, but this is what they call a premium service, where your advertisement will be featured at the top of the website for maybe a week or a month, depending on the package that you choose. However, please note that they allow someone to advertise two cars for free, up to two cars for free, and every week you have to manually renew the car. And I've used Gigi personally, I've used OLX to buy cars or to sell cars, And it's a good, if you are very careful with what you're doing, it's a good site to for you to dispose your car or for you to sell your car. The other method that one can use is social media websites like Instagram, Twitter, WhatsApp groups. There are a lot of WhatsApp groups that just deal with selling of cars. You can be able to access one of those, register yourself, you'll be able to advertise your car. We also have Car Bazaar, which takes place every week, every Sunday at Ngong Road. And at Car Bazaar, you take your car from early in the morning because you will go into a field that has a lot of vehicles. People bring in their cars and people go to the field to be able to see the cars on sale. So this happens every Sunday, Nairobi Car Bazaar, and it takes place at Ngong Racecourse. There's a small cover fee. The last time I was there, they were charging 500 shillings per each car to get into the service yard, to get into the sale yard. And I think, I've not heard whether that has increased or not, but I think it's a reasonable fee, 500. So if you're lucky and the condition of your car is good, you will just probably take it there for two or three Sundays, again depending on the urgency, on how quick you want to sell your car. And the final option that you can use are the showrooms or car dealers. And this option has got its own advantages and disadvantages. So one of the disadvantages that your car may take longer to sell, because based on your expected price, the car dealership will inflate this price because they have to make a profit from your car for the maintenance. And you know, tires and showrooms are high maintenance ventures. So if probably you're selling your car at 500,000 shillings, they'll try and sell it at 600,000 shillings, which in most cases you'll find it is a bit way above the market. So the other thing you need to know is that if it's a daily use car, then you're giving up your car. You won't have access to the car. So sometimes people opt to sell the car as they use it, and which is convenient to them. It's not advisable to put car sale stickers on your car, because in most cases it will attract jokers. It may even attract thieves or robbers or carjackers. They used to be very popular in old days, but nowadays, because of the advent of the social media and the ability to get buyers quickly through social media, then that medium does not come has become obsolete. And even at some point, the Nairobi County government had become strict on terming such practice as hawking, and they could harass you for displaying an on-sale sign on your car. So people got discouraged, and that's no longer used.